Now, maybe the worst and most dishonest thing that Kamala Harris has done, and it is a long list, my friends, is that she helped cover up Joe Biden's declining mental capacity for years. It's actually sad. Putin Xi, Kim Jong Un, all these dictators, they have been sitting in private rooms for 3.5 years, licking their chops because we have a president who can't actually do the job. Now, anyone who's too blind to see Biden's incompetence or too dishonest to admit it is not fit to serve as commander in chief. She lied to us. She lied to all of us, and it's unacceptable. And you know, they never give President Trump an easy path. Kamala Harris, the Democratic elites are trying to install her as their new nominee without her receiving a single vote for president. The media, our friends back there, they call it a coronation. I think there's another word. I call it a coup. In America, we do not crown our leaders. We vote for them. Democrat or Republican, you gotta give the voters a choice. But if there's one thing we've learned about Kamala Harris, it's that she has a hard time winning votes because she's too extreme even for the Democrat Party. Remember, in the 2020 primary, Harris dropped out months before they even cast the first vote. She was so unpopular, she polled in the low single digits among Democrats the entire campaign. She wasn't even the top three in her home state of California, and that is pretty embarrassing, ladies and gentlemen. And the reason is because Democrats know that the American people would never elect a San Francisco liberal who's so far outside the mainstream. Now, we've got to give some credit to our Democrat friends, because they were right in 2020. The American people are never going to elect a wacky, out-of-touch San Francisco liberal like Kamala Harris. Now, I saw the other day Kamala Harris questioned my loyalty to this country. That's the word she used, loyalty. And it's an interesting word, simplify, loyalty, because there is no greater sign of disloyalty to this country than what Kamala Harris has done at our southern border. And I'd like to ask the Vice President, what has she done to question my loyalty to this country? I served in the United States Marine Corps. I went to Iraq for this country. I built a business for this country. And my running mate took a bullet for this country. So my question to Kamala Harris is, what the hell have you done to question our loyalty to the United States of America? And the answer, my friends, is nothing. So let's send a message to the media. Let's send a message to Kamala Harris. Let's send a message to every hardworking patriot from Minnesota across the country. We are ready to have President Donald J. Trump back, and we're going to work our tails off to make sure it happens. God bless you all. Thank you. And thank you for having me, Minnesota, a great state.